गेट रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन. डिक्टेशन विल स्टार्ट इन 5 सेकेंड्स. स्टार्ट. दस इट इज क्लियर डैट एडहेरेंस टू द रूल ऑफ इक्वलिटी इन पब्लिक एम्प्लॉयमेंट इज अ बेसिक फीचर ऑफ अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड सिंस द रूल ऑफ लॉ इज द कोर ऑफ अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन a court would certainly be disabled from passing an order upholding a violation of article 14 or in ordering the overlooking of the need to comply with the requirements of article 14 read with article 16 of the constitution therefore consistent with the scheme of public employment This court, while laying down the law, has necessarily to hold that unless the appointment is in terms of the relevant rules and after a proper competition among qualified persons, the same would not confer any right on the appointee. If it is a contractual appointment, The appointment comes to an end at the end of the contract. If it were an engagement or appointment on daily wages, the or casual basis, the same would come to an end when it is discontinued. Similarly, a temporary employee could not claim to be made permanent on the expiry of this terms of appointment. It has also to be clarified that merely because a temporary employee or a casual wage worker is continued for a time beyond the term of his appointment, he would not be entitled to be absorbed in regular service or made permanent merely on the strength of such continuance if the original appointment was not made by following a due process of selection as envisaged by the relevant rules it is not open to the court to prevent regular recruitment at the instance of temporary employees whose period of employment has come to an end or of ad hoc employees who by the very nature of their appointment do not acquire any right. High courts acting under Article 226 of the Constitution of India should not ordinarily issue directions for absorption, regularization or permanent continuance unless the recruitment itself was made regularly and in terms of the constitutional scheme. Merely because an employee had continued under cover of an order of court which we have described as litigious employment in the earlier part of the judgment, he would not be entitled to any right to be absorbed or made permanent in the service. In fact, in such cases, the High Court may not be justified in issuing interim directions since, after all, If ultimately the employee approaching it is found entitled to relief, it may be possible for it to mold the relief in such a manner that ultimately no prejudice will be caused to him, whereas an interim direction to continue his employment would hold up the regular procedure for selection or impose on the state the burden of paying an employee who is really not required. The courts must be careful in ensuring that they do not interfere unduly with the economic arrangement of its affairs by the state or its instrumentalities or even lend themselves the instruments to facilitate the bypassing of the constitutional and statutory mandates. Full stop.